All right, Mike Richmond is here. And first of all, Mike, the history between the Redskins and Cincinnati Bengals, it is not very deep, is it?
There's not much. No, the Dan Wilkinson trade in 1998, I mean, that was supposed to be big for the Redskins. They got Dana Stubblefield same year, supposed to be really good for the defensive line, but that didn't really pan out.
Now, you had a great article this past weekend on Roy Jefferson, one of the 10 new inductees to the greatest Redskins of all time, the 10 for 80, as it was promoted during the course of the year. Overdue and well-deserving.
Well, really overdue, and I'm very happy for him. I thought he never got the credit he really deserved. And he was one of George Allen's big pickups in 1971, Allen's first year here in Washington. And he really made for a nice compliment to Charlie Taylor. Taylor went down with that season-ending injury in 1971. Jefferson stepped in, made that clutch catch in the George Allen Bowl, 70-yard bomb from Kilmer. Redskins won that game. Then a touchdown catch in the playoff game against the Packers, 72. And he had like 35 receptions per year in his six seasons here in Washington. Didn't match the numbers from previously in his career, but great, great career here in
Washington.
And
a super guy, too. I know you know him quite well.
I do,
just
yes.
A real enjoyable guy, Roy Jefferson. Congratulations again to Sweet Pea, as he was known. Now, let's focus in on something that's happening here and now. Robert Griffin III off to a great start as the Redskins starting quarterback as a rookie. And I know you know your Redskins history. There have been other rookie quarterbacks who have tried to shine early. Is anything comparable to what we've seen with RG3?
Well, nothing is really comparable in terms of passing numbers, but there have been some rookie quarterbacks who have been standouts for the Redskins. You could go back to 1961, Norm Snead. Didn't play that well in his first game, but then picked up with the numbers. Flip ahead to 1986, a name that really gets forgotten in Redskins history, Jay Schrader.
I didn't forget that name.
Technically, he wasn't a rookie in 1985. It was second season, but he had thrown only a few passes previously, but stepped in for Theismann when Theismann had that horrific injury.
Right.
And really put up some great numbers in that season. And then Rippon, 1988. Again, second year he had been active the previous year, though, in the NFL. Gus Frerotte, too.
Right, but nobody really compares to Robert, as he is a first-year player, fresh out of college, lighting it up, right?
Oh, exactly. You're exactly right, yes. Nobody passing or rushing either.
Never know.
Didn't
one day.
Sammy do well his rookie year, Larry?
Who?
Sammy.
Sammy Baugh. I wasn't there. But Sammy Baugh, of course,
you were.
Came with a lot of hype, just like Robert. Different era, though, obviously a different time. But, you know, one day, Robert Griffin III might be in one of your books, which are available. Here's your chance to plug them.
Thank you, Larry. Yes, both of my books, The Washington Redskins Football Vault and The Redskins Encyclopedia, are available by going to my website, redskinshistorian.com.